Over on the other side of the political fence, Republicans are having a field day. Donald Trump casting doubt on Biden's COVID diagnosis. He claims Biden wanted to drop out of the race right after their June 27 debate, calling it a big moment in Biden's demise. In another post, Trump called Biden the worst president in U.S. history. Trump's running mate, meanwhile, criticized both Biden and U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris and their policies. As for Republican House Speaker Mike Johnson, he warns of legal obstacles should Biden be replaced on the Democratic ticket.
14 million Democrats voted to make Joe Biden the nominee. So it would be wrong and I think unlawful in accordance to some of these states' rules for a handful of people to go in a back room and switch it out because they don't like the candidate any longer. You know, Donald Trump may be headed for a landslide. Now, don't take my word for it. Take the word of some of the top leading Democrats and, you know, elected Democrats around the country who are in panic mode. That's the headlines that we've been reading for weeks, and I think that's true.
With a major shakeup in the race for the White House. After weeks of intense pressure from his own party, U.S. President Joe Biden drops his re-election bid. In a letter posted on X, Biden wrote, "It's been the greatest honor of his life to serve the American people as their president." But he said, while it was his intention to seek re-election, it is in the best interest of his party and the U.S. that he stand down and focus on the remainder of his term. Biden said he will address the American people later this week about his decision. His decision comes nearly a month after his shaky debate performance against rival Donald Trump. It also came days after he tested positive for COVID-19. Soon after Biden's announcement, he endorsed U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris as the Democratic presidential nominee. Biden says he offers his full support for Harris as he called on Democrats to come together in order to beat Republican nominee Donald Trump. Harris responded, thanking Biden for his leadership and decades of service. He also said she's honored to have Biden's endorsement, adding it is her intention to earn and win the nomination. Harris could be the first Black woman and first Asian American to lead the ticket of a majority political party. Several notable Democrats praising Biden's leadership as he withdraws from the 2024 race. In a statement, Bill and Hillary Clinton thanked Biden for what they called an extraordinary career that lifted the U.S. out of the pandemic and rebuilt a battered economy. The two also vowed to do whatever they can to support U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris and her potential White House bid. Former U.S. President Barack Obama, meanwhile, described Biden as one of the most consequential presidents and a patriot of the highest order. Former U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi echoes Obama's statement. She said Biden is a leader who always puts the country first. A panel of the Democratic National Convention expressing profound sadness after Biden dropped his re-election bid.
We are saddened that he is stepping aside as a candidate, but we know that he always puts the country first. And I am personally reassured and enthusiastic that from now until January 20, he will continue to be a strong president of the United States as he has been for the past 3.5 years.
I am emotional about the president's decision because this president, Joe Biden, has been a transformational president. He's been a great leader. He's a good man, a decent man, who has done so much for this nation, but so much to see us as people, to value us, to fight for us.
Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manoto.
I'm TJ Manotok, and this is your TFC News Now.
Severe thunderstorms hit Toronto earlier this week and caused widespread flooding and disruption throughout the city, leaving commuters stranded and more than 160,000 residents without power. Kim Benefuerte and her kids were stuck on a highway for hours.
I had to shut down my car. I didn't have enough gas. I was more concerned because I have my kids with me. I don't think Torontonians are prepared for this kind of situation.
Lori Del Rosario's family heard a loud explosion before water gushed from the rooftop of their 25-floor apartment building, forcing a quick evacuation.
May pumutok na pipe sa bubong ng building. Yung sound is really, really loud. Sabi ko nga sa misis ko, baka may tinamaan ng kidlat. There's a lot of lightning yesterday. And then my wife told me there's no water. And the next, no lights. And the announcement, evacuate the building, is a transformer exploded.
And finally, about 230 delegates from all over the United States are flying out of Philippine Airlines U.S. gateways, New York, Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Honolulu to take part in the Philippine Department of Tourism's very important Pinoy or VIP tour beginning this weekend. The July 21 to 30 tour takes PhilAms to Manila, Bacolod, Iligan, and Cagayan de Oro and promises to be a one-of-a-kind cultural experience for participants.
We are excited to welcome you soon here in the City of Smiles. Famous for the vibrant Mascara Festival, our culinary heritage is equally renowned. This July, I hope you will experience the warmth and hospitality of Bacolodons, whether you're reconnecting with your roots, exploring investment opportunities, or enjoying a new cultural experience. Bacolod is ready to welcome you with open arms.
And those are the top stories making the headlines today. You can catch more of our TFC News on our ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manoto.
Israel's supreme leader defiant following the latest Israeli attacks across Gaza, which killed at least 39 Palestinians. Ayatollah Ali Khamenei says the Jewish state cannot bring resistance to its knees as he accuses Israeli forces of the highest crimes and violence. His comments come a day after Israel also struck the Iranian-backed Houthis near Yemen's Hodeidah port, killing 6 and injuring 80 others. The Houthis and Hamas are part of what has been called the Axis of Resistance, an anti-Israel and anti-Western alliance of regional militias backed by Iran. Meanwhile, a Houthi leader says the retaliatory strike on Hodeidah port would not benefit Israel. He added the airstrikes on Saturday would not deter operations of their group. A rare Houthi drone strike on Friday hit Tel Aviv, killing one person, prompting Israel to announce its first strikes against the group. Israeli officials say Hodeidah port has been used by the Houthis to receive weapons shipments from Iran. Pope Francis expressing hope the Paris Olympics would be an occasion for a ceasefire in ongoing conflicts. During his weekly address at St. Peter's Square, the Pope said he hoped that according to ancient tradition, the Games will be an opportunity to establish a truce, mentioning the conflicts in Ukraine, Gaza, Myanmar, and other countries. He also urged athletes to be messengers of peace and models for young people. The final statement of the group of seven leaders meeting held in Italy last month included a unanimous call for a truce in global conflicts during the Olympic Games.